I've tried. I really like the grip on the left thumbstick for the.
I like everything about
controller.
It except the stick. And it's not the stick. It's just the idea. I just need jags. Maybe I should just mod it.
No. I'm talking on the GameCube controller.
Oh.
Anyway,
the GameCube controller is the best controller in the world. I can't wait till it breaks my hands in 10 years. Here we go. PS2 Game One.
Yep. So this is an interesting matchup. I haven't actually seen any Inkling versus Captain Falcon, especially Nixie's Captain Falcon.
I've seen Nixie's fought John before.
Yes, I'm sure he has. I just haven't seen it.
Yeah, it's a fun matchup. It's a bunch of it's gonna be Inkling doing a lot of this, keeping him off stage, trying to just like keep him at arm's length.
Yes.
Length.
See, that's the thing. As far as boxing someone in the air goes, I feel like Falcon wins most interactions, except where. Oh, well, he was fully. He was.
Is New York free?
I don't know.
Is New York City free right now?
We'll find out. We'll see if an invader can take it and move on to Great.
I feel like so every Xeno since week one of Ultimate, we've had a New York City player win.
Yes.
So if Wishes wins this, that'd be history.
That would be history. That would absolutely be something to see. But
quote me if I'm wrong, Devin, but I'm pretty sure that's true.
Nixie has no pushover, though. He's kind of playing a little bit behind right now, but ooh, that's no jump either. Oh, he doesn't actually go up safe for that one. Falcon
of course kick. Nixie would just wake up Falcon kick.
Look, Nick
the
does,
soft hit of... Okay.
Nixie does just the right amount of random, and you cannot convince me otherwise.
The thing is, you think it's random, it's all strategized.
Yes.
That Falcon kick right there, for instance, he went for it because he knew if it went like it did, he was safe.
Yes.
Because of the distance, he used it that. Okay, looking for that down tilt, try to catch that super jump.
Yes, you actually noticed that he was crouching there, which allowed stuff to whiff over his head a little bit. That was mad smart. Nixie is actually like a low-key genius. All right.
Okay,
he's coming back.
Nick has had stage control for quite some time. Who does that?
That was such a weird reset. Yo, see, we see that again, trying to go for the anti-air off of Reed right there.
And Wishes nice. Calls
Yo.
It out yet again with another up smash. My God.
Yo, Nixie is not free, but Wishes is kind of making him look like he is.
Looking like Suarez versus Nixie, good God.
Oh. All right, once again. So no reset on that one, nah. Falcon's too heavy.
Nick definitely just mashed down tilt there. He's like, he recognized what was going on. He's like, not you fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me, man.
Yep. You see a really good job there of air dodging out of the up tilt on that one. He actually teched the up tilt as well before, so he seems to at least have a good idea of what Falcon wants to look for and how to beat it. That was a really good pivot grab from him.
And just slams him into the ground.
Wishes actually covering the platform there, then going in on the ground. That's really good. Falcon also has difficulty, or at least I know he didn't smash for, and I'm sure the weakness carries over.
Talk about that up smash.
Yes.
Just for like
the
five
fact minutes. That that worked, I think.
No,
was good.
Yeah, of course it would work. He knew what he was doing, but he knew that he was going to go for the roll to the right. He keeps trying to go for the soft spot in there because that's exactly what he's trying to do again and again. A second up B coming out. Can we get a third?
Oh my God, he had the right read, but he went too far.
Parries the roller, no punish. That could have been an easy shield grab, but he wants something bigger.
Yep. Goes for the.
He's
dead. That'll kill him. Yep.
Yeah. Honestly, the reason he was going off stage like that is because he was trying to go, not for the soft hit of forward air to the knee. He actually wanted like the sweet spot to kill him off stage like completely.
Yes.
But he'll take the soft spot, and then the second he recognizes that lands. Sees the tech coming in, tries to go for the immediate punish. You saw him going for the platform on the right side that right after he did that. Got the big punish, not enough to get the kill though, and he just struggle bust after that. And the second he lost all of his resources. He committed to the double jump. He got smacked by the little splat gun.
And see, that was the first time that he'd gone hard off stage like that because he wanted to mix that in a little bit to try to catch him off guard. But
nah, he's been going hard the whole time, man.
He's been going hard.
He's
been going hard, but he hasn't been running deep off stage like that, like as soon as he gets the person off stage.
You know, right.
So that was sort of a mix-up in itself, but he does pay for it with his life, which is unfortunate. Also, can we talk about how both Nick and Dill are using Banjo-Kazooie tags? We got the guh-huh, and then we got the beacom-bokom.
Wait, what?
Yeah. Guh-huh? That's Banjo.
Yes.
Yeah. And then Dill was using beacom-bokom.
Oh, right. I thought you were talking about the Ad Geno tag. I was like, what in the world?
No. I don't know. Was Geno in Banjo? I've never actually played either game.
No, he was not.
No.
Right. Super Mario RPG, you uncultured swine.
No, I know he was in Super Mario RPG.
Right, here we go. Get the up right. throw. Wants the up air right afterwards. Bada bing, bada boom. Gonna get that stock.
Very clean. Wasn't it funny how we were talking about how Inkling has no kill power when Wishes has now
there's
for
a
the
window.
Second
there's
game.
There's a window there where is. You get that grab, you get the up throw, you get the up air, and Wishes actually knows how to do it, unlike John.
No, not just that. I'm talking where he Wishes has consistently been getting to super high percents and just not dying. I say as he dies off stage to a jab.
I mean, honestly, Captain Falcon's jab off stage. You get that gentleman's hit. It's gonna get the kill. Nice and easy lemon squeezy.
I'm not sure Captain Falcon is a gentleman, but he makes the gentleman work. All right, backing up.
I'm sure he holds the door open.
Yeah. He's probably always does it in a hurry.
Yeah.
It's like, are you going the same way I'm going? Yes!
Man, it says Falcon Polite all over him. Okay, 105 on Nick. He is struggle busting right now. See him, like, he's at that prime percent where if Wishes is going to be looking for that grab, look at he's hungry for it. He went for a dash grab. He's going to get super punished for it. Mm-hmm. Not too much damage.
Yep. See, another thing that I think is really important here is that Falcon kind of struggles a little bit against low profile, right? So his grab does whiff on Inkling's. Yo, is that it? Yes. Very nice.
Roller's going to give him that guaranteed kill. Wishes one stock away from being guaranteed. In Grand's Finals, top two here at Xeno. The first invader to actually win a Xeno. Could it perchance be possible?
It's looking kind of rough for Nick right now. Yo, kicks him, but doesn't get hit by the bomb. That was pretty good.
There we go. You saw him arching it up, so that was Nick sees like prime time to go for a low-profile down tilt. Yes.
He drops it on the jab. That is unfortunate. All right. Good chase off stage. See, Nick can still do this. I think if Nick gets something here pretty quick, as long as he doesn't get hit too much when he's inked up, he can take this.
And you see him delaying those down airs as well before landing on the ground, because if he does that, it allows him to be able to respond with a knee quicker. And if he whiffs, it gives him plenty of time to like get away from any sort of punish after Wishes. Just very good movement coming from Nick.
Yes, less punishable the lower you hit it on the shield. Yo, rolls behind, tries to go for the grab. That was sneaky.
I mean, it was pretty obvious because there was so much time in between the roll and the grab that Wishes had all the time in the world to react to it.
Yes.
Like, he didn't have to read that. He just reacted. Okay, 133%. I like that he baited it out with a double jump so he didn't have to get caught by that down air. He gets spiked to oblivion.
Yep. Doing a good job trying to hit him out here. You see, he's getting the straight hits, but he's just not finding the kills on this one. Inkling looking to 144. There we go.
Finally finds his mark. Puts the boot on Inkling, and this could be the start of the momentum that Nick needs. Hold on a sec. He's got the nares. Up airs.
Okay, Phantom Footstool off of the up air. That was actually sick, and gets him off of the mix-up situation right after. I've never seen that.
Okay, he's really hungry for the grab. Gets the back air, calls it out with a down smash.
That was good. This is actually super scary.
It covered
scary
a lot of options.
This
covers the neutral
really
get up, covers
scary.
The rolls to the right. Now he's sitting at 94% offstage. Trying to get the gentleman's. He just rolled
what
out of there.
What happened to the momentum?
He wanted the air dodge. He
literally
the
30 seconds. Nick went to like, oh my god. No, he has his jump. He's good.
He's not good. He's call out from Wishes. Not letting that momentum gain from Nixie catch him off guard, because that was starting to look super scary for him, but it manages to call out Nick. Jumps off stage, kicks him in the face, sends him flying, and then we got someone in New Jersey sitting in Grand Finals. Wishes. Who could stop him?
I don't know. We'll see.
Who could stop him?
Nick right now sitting in, I don't know if he would be in Loser Semis or Loser's Finals. Loser's Finals, but we could see him come back for the run back. We could see someone else in Loser's right now. I think Dill is still sitting down there currently. But I don't know. Right now, Wishes has been looking pretty dominant. It looks like... We saw earlier, once he changed over to Inkling, we haven't seen like too much of a struggle since.
All I'm saying is if Wishes wins this tournament, I'm New Jersey.
You're New Jersey?
I'm New Jersey if Wishes wins.
You're picking up another one of those FNY badges?
No, I'm just you know, giving up my affiliation with New York City. I'm going to start going to Spectrum on Mondays. Xeno, what's that?
Xeno?
I don't even know.